This came from a resident, and the question is this. Could you outline your stance on strategies to deal with mentally ill people with a history of violent behavior? And what strategy would you and your party take to reduce violent crime? And they're like, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to make the executive decisions. I think those are entirely separate questions. One is not to do with the criminal law, it's to do with people who are ill. So let's talk about, let's just stop it. Could you outline your stance on strategies to deal with mentally ill people, some of whom have a history of violent behaviors? I know that is something that's a reality in large parts of town, including this one. So let me go ahead.
Well, one of the things we have to do, of course, is have a lot more supports out there for them. And I was at a homeless shelter the other day, and they were pointing out that, in fact, for the homeless, there's absolutely no services in the mental health area. We've seen the kind of tragedies that this has led to in terms of situations where people with mental problems end up in confrontations with the police. And so, you know, what we want to do is move away from that type of problem as much as possible. And one of the things, we know one way to do that is to provide more supports for people with mental problems. One of the impacts of all the cutbacks we've seen in the past 30 years is that essentially the people that used to be in situations in mental hospitals have been kind of thrown out onto the street. It's this lack of public support for people in difficult situations, including mental health situations, that's causing so many of the problems in our society.
Yeah, I think we might find this is another area where we're all in violent agreement with one another. You know, we absolutely need to support people with mental health problems much more, and it is connected to our previous housing conversation. I was at the Regent Park Christian Resource Center, where they have deeply discounted housing, and some of the people who are there, they said some of their main clientele is people who, because of their mental health problems, have ended up without homes. So these problems are really connected, and not providing the support to people who need it ends up causing both huge personal tragedies, but also ultimately as a society costing us more money.
Tom, I haven't given detailed thought to this question, and I'm not going to pretend that I have, but what I can tell you is this. This is an opposition riot, and no matter who wins the election on November 25th, Stephen Harper will still be the Prime Minister of Canada. And the policies that we're talking about here will not be Linda's policies or Tom Mulcair's policies or Justin Trudeau's policies or Elizabeth May's policies. It'll be Stephen Harper's policies until the opposition parties find an agreed way to get rid of Stephen Harper's undeserved majority of the party.
All right, you want to have any questions? I'll just pick up on the second part of the question.